The following is a sports presentation of Q100.
Orleans girls basketball's on the air. WFLQ Q100 presents exciting coverage of Orleans Lady Bulldogs basketball. Tonight's game between the Orleans Lady Bulldogs and the Christian Academy Lady Warriors being brought to you by Busick Insurance in Orleans for home, farm, health, auto, life, and business. Call 865-2626. Hall Brothers Transportation in Orleans, meeting the shipping needs of the area for more than a decade. Orange County REMC, offering affordable long distance. Call 865-2229. Pipe Dreams Incorporated in Bedford for energy efficient furnaces. Call 279-9594. Super Clean Car Wash, Maple Street, Orleans, and by Sullivan Financial, Raymond James and Associates Investments, Highway 60 and 9th Street in Mitchell. And now, Lady Bulldog Basketball. Let's go courtside with Q100's Mike Hamilton, color by Aaron Free.
Good evening, everyone, from Christian Academy High School in New Albany, Indiana. This is Spring Orleans Girls Basketball. As this evening, the Lady Bulldogs taking on Christian Academy. We'll have the starting lineups and tip-off when we return. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
When it comes to buying insurance, you want a company that will take the guesswork out of finding the proper coverage at premiums that are affordable. At the Busick Insurance Agency in Orleans, your auto owner's agent, they'll work with you to determine the right amount of coverage. To get the best protection for home, health, auto, life, and business, call Patton or Brett Busick or Josh Crocker or Richard Grace at the Busick Insurance Agency, your auto owner's agent on East Jefferson Street in Orleans at 865-2626. Busick Insurance, a proud supporter of Orleans Bulldog Sports.
Hall Brothers Transportation in Orleans, a name that has stood for dependability for many years, is proud to continue their support of the Orleans Bulldogs and to the many events and activities of the school and the community as well. They realize the importance athletics have on our young people in building character and to adults in experiencing the thrill of high school sports. Hall Brothers Transportation has been serving the shipping needs of much of the Midwest, providing the link to keep businesses strong and our area's economy growing.
Hall Brothers Transportation, Highway 37 in Orleans, serving the area since 1979.
Welcome you into Christian Academy High School here in New Albany as the Lady Bulldogs and Lady Warriors get set to do battle. Orleans trying to bounce back from their first defeat on Thursday night when they fell to, or Friday night I should say, to the Bloomfield Lady Cardinals by a score of 54-46. Meanwhile, Christian Academy under first-year head coach Chris Jefferson in perhaps a little bit of a rebuilding mode, as they have struggled in their first three contests, averaging just 12 points a game while losing to New Washington, West Washington, and to Lanesville. All right, a quick look at the starting lineups for Christian Academy. It is Ella McCoy and Aaron Stensrud. They'll be the forwards and the three-guard trio, Ann Lopez, Ashlyn Owen, and Caitlin Estes. For Orleans, it'll be Audrey Elrod at forward, a 5'7 senior, 6' sophomore Haley Powell to center, and the guard Sheridan Robbins, Sydney Moon, and Jack Gerken. We're underway as the pass is controlled by Christian Academy. On the right side, Ann Lopez has got it as Orleans starts off in a man-to-man. Picking up her dribble is Aaron Stensrud, looking to get rid of it. Got to be a 5-second count, and that is the case. So
good defense that time by Haley Powell on the to get the 5-second call.
So the first turnover, and Orleans will have an opportunity to get on the board first as a 3-2 zone being employed by Christian Academy. But even at that, they work it in low to Haley Powell, and she misses the shot. The rebound grabbed by Caitlin Estes, and she had trouble controlling the ball and is called for a traveling violation. Ball comes in to Sydney Moon, top of the key now to Audrey Elrod. In low, wide open as Jack Gerken missed the layup, got it back, had it blocked away, and it'll stay with Orleans.
Would have liked to see her go up strong that time. She went up very tentatively and missed it.
Off the inbound, here's Sheridan Robbins launching a three off the rim. Sydney Moon, the offensive rebound. So a second chance opportunity here for the Lady Bulldogs. Now it looks like a 1-2-2 zone being employed by Christian Academy. Out along the perimeter as Gerken works it around now to Moon. Sydney to the baseline. In low to Haley Powell for the catch. And easy lay-in. So the Lady Bulldogs not wasting any time, pounding it inside. They get the first basket of the contest. Now we're going to see some full court pressure, and that's going to turn into a 5-second count. Already the third turnover by Christian Academy. Gerken, oh, and there's the Orleans first turnover as the ball bounced at the feet of Sheridan Robbins by Jack Gerken. So the turnover there gives it back to the Lady Warriors. Again, Orleans continuing to apply full court pressure as it comes in to Estes, and she's going to be called for a traveling violation.
That's already four turnovers against Christian Academy. How many times do you think I'll say Graceland Christian tonight? I'm afraid of doing that. So, Christian Academy.
Right. Jerking down to the corner. Still no score. We have played a minute and a half. In low, Haley Powell, actually 2-0 on Haley's short jumper, but she just had her shot rejected as Aaron Stendrew got a piece of that. Orleans trying to get it going here in the early going. Moon down the corner to Gerken. She'll launch a three. It's off the rim with the rebound pulled out of there by Aaron Stendrew. Off it comes now to Lopez. She'll bring it up the court. Takes it to the left corner. Crosses hands with the dribble. Cross courts the feed now to Caitlin Estes, and her pass stolen away by Moon. Sydney on the drive to the basket, backs her way in, puts it up, couldn't get the shot to go. Tipped around, grabbed by Sheridan Robbins, and they're going to call her for an offensive foul. She just kind of lowered her shoulder and leaned in to the Christian Academy defender. So Sheridan picks up the game's first personal here, a little over 2 minutes into the contest.
Just a sloppy start to this ball game, I think, for both teams.
Absolutely. Sometimes a step down when you go up against a team that maybe is not as fundamentally sound as some of the other teams. Here's a quick three by Lopez, banked it too hard, and Gerken outfought Estes for the rebound. Still 2-0 Orleans, as Robbins quickly works it into the front court, sends a pass left wing to Elrod. Audrey, a couple of dribbles, back between the circles now where Robbins has got it. Sheridan comes back on the near side to Elrod. Now they swing it around on the right wing to Gerken. In low to Haley Powell. Puts it up no good, but does draw contact. And Haley will try to earn a couple.
I like
at
that.
The straight.
I like that set that time from Orleans. They went and cleared out the side for Audrey and then got the ball into Haley. Ball's got to go inside and get the ball in the middle, and that's why you work against a trap like that.
The foul call went on Aaron Stensrud. That is her first of the contest. First on Christian Academy is Haley Powell. Unsuccessful on the first one, missed the second one, and Stensrud able to grab the rebound. Still 2-0 Orleans on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, almost 3 minutes gone by. Lopez on the right wing, backs it out to near center court. Maintaining the dribble, slides off the screen. Stop and go move, takes it into the lane, lost the handle. Robbins has got it. Now she is bumped and fouled, and now Aaron Stensrud has just picked up her second personal foul. So this is not a deep team anyway. Only 8 players on the entire roster for the Lady Warriors. So Stensrud will come out, and Casey Souter, a 5'8 sophomore, will check into the lineup. There's Haley, or rather Sydney Moon, wide open in low. She missed the layup, but Haley Powell, the rebound, no good. Sydney Moon gets it to Elrod, lost it between her legs, tracks it down, gets it over now to Gerken. Boy, a shaky start here for the Lady Bulldogs. Getting some point-blank shots, not getting it. There's a weak side pass through the hands of Haley Powell, and it's picked up by Caitlin Estes. I don't think Jared Gilbert's going to have much patience to see what his team is doing here. We're approaching the halfway point of the first quarter. Orleans pitching a shutout, but at the same time, they've only scored 2 points themselves. And there's a ball knocked away from Lopez, picked up by Elrod. So Audrey will get credit for the steal. Durkin pushing it into the front court, works it right side to Moon. In low this time, Sheridan Robbins is wide open for the layup. And a quick timeout called by Chris Jefferson, who's in his first year and in the Lady Warriors, kind of in a rebuilding mode with only eight on the team. But again, like we saw with Rock Creek Academy on Saturday when Springs Valley played them, Aaron Freed, and as we, of course, bring in assistant principal Aaron Freed, this is kind of a volleyball school.
Yes.
They just won the state championship here a little over 3 years ago.
Had a girl that was really, really tough. I remember going to the University of Kentucky.
They were, right, they were state runners-up this year.
Yes.
So, you know, they're a 2A in volleyball because of the success factor having to move up. So sometimes in private schools, you have situations where really only one particular sport may dominate.
Yeah, and that's, I think that's going on here at Christian Academy. It's a rebuilding year for them, as we've talked about. But as we've I think this is one of those things where Orleans has kind of got off to a slow start. I don't know what the reason for that would be. Sometimes if you have a varsity game only and the girls are used to watching the game, but and you know, if your opponent's only had off to a rough start, sometimes you get to read some of that. But when the game starts, you just got to play, and it looks like Orleans wasn't ready to play to start the game.
Into the front court comes Lopez, and she gets tied up by Peyton Blanton, who has just checked into the ball game now for the Lady Dogs. Peyton, a 5'7 sophomore, averaging 6.5 a game.
Now, I say that, and Christian Academy's got 8 turnovers. They haven't scored yet, but Orleans has missed some point-blank range looks.
Right. Here's Gherkin, right wing, up top now to Jenna Hall, who's also checked in now for Orleans. Jenna, 5'6 sophomore. She's got us the point. Flashing into the lane goes Lily Pridemore, and she is called for a double dribble.
The third turnover against Orleans. Just don't look comfortable against that zone that Christian Academy is applying right now.
I say Jared Gilbert substituting 3 different players here. And perhaps, again, his patience running thin. Still 4-0, 3:25 to go here in the opening quarter. On the high post is Lopez around the screen, drives in, puts it up, couldn't get the shot to go. Fight for the rebound. Primore had it. Ball knocked free, and Peyton Blanton out of there with it. She'll send it back the other way. Weak side pass to Audrey Elrod, who puts up the jumper. It spins off, and the rebound yanked out of there by Lopez. Tries the outlet pass, and unable to save it is Ashlyn Owen, and Orleans will keep possession of the basketball. Same crew that we had for the Springs Valley and Rock Creek Academy game on Saturday doing this one. Dick Canoy and his crew. Here's a long three by Jenna Hall that's no good. Lily Pridemore, the rebound, back up and good. So Lily sneaks in there for the putback. And Orleans has extended their lead now to 6-0 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. Quickly into the front court comes Estes. Stops in the corner, brings it out of the wing now where Owen's got it. Just a freshman, slides off the screen. Ball knocked away, picked up by Gherkin. Outlet to a breaking Peyton Blanton. Little crossover move, had it blocked away. Grabbed out of there by Caitlin Estes, and now she is called for a traveling violation. And again, you can see in a situation where you've got a young team, such as Christian Academy, they have no seniors on the team, just 2 juniors, so 2 sophomores and 4 freshmen on the squad. Nice feed in low. Lily Pridemore doing a nice job to work herself free underneath the basket. She has 4 early points, and now Orleans methodically trying to extend the lead here. It's up to 8-0 now.
Lily has done a nice job providing a spark off the bench.
Missed 3 here by Estes, and another Orleans rebound. Blanton quickly into the front court. Lady Bulldogs have started to get untracked offensively thanks to this new unit. Elrod in the corner, fakes, drives in, had it knocked away. Ball being tapped around. Gherkin finally grabs it to Blanton along the perimeter. Tip pass to Elrod, looking inside for Pridemore. Said angles a pass off to Peyton Blanton for a three that is no good. But again, Orleans being very active. Comes up with the offensive rebound. Elrod, who takes it down the lane, hit the bottom of the backboard with that. And Casey Souter, the rebound. 1:20 to go, opening quarter, 8-0 Orleans. Christian Academy still looking for their first points here. Remember, they only averaged 12 a game. On the high post, knocked away, good anticipation. Elrod, pass up court now to Blanton, who takes it in, and it rolls in, count it, and a three-point play opportunity.
Able to get the basket, and now she's going to get a free throw out of it. Audrey with a nice pass at half court to get her the ball as well.
Ashlyn Owen called for the foul. That'll be her first, third on the team. Peyton Blanton. It's her first field goal of the contest, and the three-point play opportunity. She makes the most of it as it goes in. So already 7 bench points now for the Lady Bulldogs. And just like that, the lead has blossomed to 11-0. Even though the scoreboard a little slow in putting that extra point on now, it is. Again, full court pressure. Lopez gets it off now to Owen. Had it knocked away. It'll belong to Christian Academy. But right now, the Lady Warriors are struggling to get the ball across the 10-second line.
I have them for 12 turnovers in the quarter, Mike.
They've only taken 3 shots thus far. Lopez gets it in to Estes, and she traveled with the basketball. Started to make a pass and jumped up and down. And already, a baker's dozen in turnovers. Wow. That is a bunch already. Final minute, opening quarter. Orleans starting to take command. Moon baseline to Haley Powell, who takes it right along the baseline, scoops it up and in. That's her 4th point. And it's now 13-0. Orleans.
I like Haley Powell attacking from the baseline. I think that was a good move there.
And Christian Academy able to finally break the pressure as they get a shot off in the lane that time. Owen had an opportunity but shot it too hard. Orleans couldn't come up with a rebound. So Christian Academy, maybe one last chance here in the quarter to get their first points as they try to work it in low to McCoy. And Sheridan Robbins got over there and was able to knock it away. Estes gets it in, intended for Lopez, and Orleans doing a good job of anticipating passes here. And Sydney Moon was able to knock that one out of bounds. Estes gets it in along the baseline, and it goes to Owen, who had it knocked away. Coaches anymore talk about all those deflections and how important those are. And oh, thrown right into Sydney Moon, who's on a break to the other end, and she gets the steal and coast-to-coast layup, her first basket, and make it 15-0. And Orleans steals it in the backcourt. Nope, Peyton Blanton couldn't quite hang on to it as she dribbled the ball on the sideline. So 13:07 left. Again, more full court pressure, and the ball comes in to Estes, and she stepped out of bounds. Thought they were going to call the foul on Orleans since there was some contact.
I think he might have got away with one there, but we'll take
12:04 left. Robbins works it in now to Jenna Hall. Out along the three-point arc, back to Blanton, in low to Haley Powell, takes one dribble and banks one up and in. Her 6th point of the contest.
When she gets her shoulder square at the basket, she's good about making the shot. So it's good offense from Orleans.
And from half court, the tip by Owen is no good. That'll do it for the opening quarter. Took Lady Dogs a while to get going, but they finally did. And after one on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, they lead Christian Academy 17-0. Back with the second quarter in a moment. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
You've worked hard to build and protect your estate throughout your lifetime. Enjoy the confidence that comes from knowing all you've worked for may be preserved for your heirs. Please call Jamie Sullivan, Senior Vice President of Investments of Sullivan Financial Consulting of Raymond James, located in Mitchell, at 849-2670. Jamie can help design a comprehensive plan suited for your family's future financial needs. Call Jamie Sullivan today at 849-2670. Raymond James & Associates Incorporated, member New York Stock Exchange, SIPC.
Orange County REMC is now offering you affordable protection for your home. Home security systems are available for members and non-members and will provide protection from fire, carbon monoxide, and theft. These systems are continuously monitored so you'll have a peace of mind whether you're at home, work, or on vacation. You might even qualify for a discount on your homeowner's premium. Packages starting at $199 with monitoring starting at $2495. For more information on these home services, call Orange County REMC at 812-865-2229.
Back once again to Christian Academy here in New Albany. It's been all Lady Bulldogs. They struggled to get going. They had only 2 points to the almost halfway point of the opening quarter, but they finally got things generated, and they've done a lot of it out of their bench, who has contributed 7 of their 17 points, 4 by Lily Pridemore and 3 by Peyton Blanton.
The two sophomores, Lily and Peyton, came off the bench, gave a spark, and really got Orleans going there.
Orleans in their traveling black uniforms with red numbers, red letters, and red trim. Christian Academy in their home white uniforms with gold lettering, blue numbers, and blue and gold lettering. Old Notre Dame colors. Even better, caramel colors.
The Greyhounds,
Pass almost intercepted by Haley Powell. Picked up, though, by McCoy. And she gets tied up by Haley Powell. And that'll give the ball to Orleans on the alternating possession.
16th turnover against Christian Academy.
Wow. In a 3-2 zone being employed by Christian Academy. Gherkin at the point, down to the corner to Robin. Sheridan will launch a 3-pointer, airballed it. Rebound to Sydney Moon, off to Audrey Elrod. She'll try it from downtown, wouldn't go. Sheridan Robbins, the offensive rebound, goes back up and draws a 2-shot foul. Again, Christian Academy not very active on the boards. A lot of offensive rebounds here and second and third chance opportunities. Ella McCoy calls the foul, her first, the fourth now on Christian Academy. Fourth and fifth free throws by Orleans as Sheridan could not get the first one to drop. Second one is good, and Sheridan has her third point. It's 18 to nothing now with a big lead. Lady Dogs will relinquish the press, and driving all the way coast to coast for Christian Academy's first basket of the game is Ashlyn Owen. She took it up the right side, got a screen at quarter court, and nobody from Orleans came over to defend, and she had the easy layup. Moon, a baseline drive, tried to feed it in low, lost, picked up by Sheridan Robbins, drives into lane. Tries to bank one, no good. Rebound, Haley Powell, no good. She'll try again, and this time we'll draw another foul. These girls probably not padding their shooting percentage numbers, but at least
seven offensive rebounds for Orleans in this ballgame. But like you said, he doesn't make the first one.
So Haley missed two in the opening quarter, and that one she leaves short. One more try, that one no good as well, and a nice block out here by Ashlyn Owen. 18-2, Orleans with the lead, a little over a minute gone by here in the second quarter. Picking up her dribble is McCoy, and threw it right into the hands of Jack Gerken. Gerken in there along with Sidney Moon, Sheridan Robbins, Audrey Elrod, and Haley Powell. There's Sidney all alone underneath the basket. Missed it, but there for the opportunistic putback is Haley Powell. So she's been active. That's her eighth point of the contest. And it's 20-2 Orleans. Off the screen goes Owen, and she had it knocked away as she got to the baseline. Pretty simple what Christian Academy's doing. They have one person bringing it down, one that sets the screen at quarter court, and then they try to get an easy layup based on that. Lopez on the high post to McCoy. Her shot would not go. Good block out by Gerken. Jack crosses the 10-second line, baseline to Elrod. Cross-courts the feed to Robbins, who spots up for a 12-footer and knocks it down. Sheridan Robbins has her fifth point of the contest. And it's 22-2. From the other end goes Owen. Hands off now to Lopez, top of the circle. Turns, had it knocked away. Loose, picked up by Gerken again. So again, Lady Warriors very careless with the basketball. Here's Elrod on the left wing. Feeds it in low. Nice catch in traffic by Sheridan Robbins, who finishes off with two more. 24-2, and now an official's timeout here to allow Ann Lopez to tie her shoe.
Really nice pass by Audrey Elrod to see her. And then, like you said, nice catch by Sheridan Robbins, almost like a receiver right there.
Right. 5:10 to go here in the first half. Owen into the front court. Orleans picking up man-to-man. Owen feeds it right side. Works grabbed there by Ashton Neighbors, who's checked into the ball game. She's a 5'3 freshman. Over on the high post to Owen. And, oh, Chris Jefferson wanted a timeout. Official didn't hear it. Orleans gets the steal, and driving to the other end was Audrey Elrod, who missed the layup. Putback attempt by Sheridan Robbins wouldn't go, and now Christian Academy has it. 4:35, and now Chris Jefferson will get a timeout that he wants. And this will be a 30-second timeout with 4:35 to go here in the opening half. And on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, Orleans comfortably in front, 24-2. Landis Insurance in Orleans is serious about protecting you and your interests. They represent Hastings Mutual. And Landis is ready to satisfy your auto, home, farm, business, or other insurance needs. Hastings Mutual and Landis, together providing Midwestern value since 1885. All the Landis agents in Orleans at 865-4792. Well, so far, maybe except for the first 3 or 4 minutes of the contest, Aaron, things generally going as expected.
Yeah, just got off to a slow start. That happens sometimes, and you just got to keep playing. They were getting good shots. They weren't making them, but they were playing hard, playing pretty good defense. You just got to like see them put the ball in the basket to start the game.
To the baseline goes Lopez. Sealed off there, tries to feed it in low. It's knocked away, stolen by Elrod. Audrey on a break to the other end, scoops it up too hard. Sheridan Robbins back up, wouldn't go. And Sheridan will try a third time, and this time it will indeed drop. Sheridan's seventh point here in this quarter. And the lead continues to grow. It's 26-2. Down the lane goes Owen. Fired one up too hard. Here's Robbins back the other way. Baseline to Elrod. In low to Moon, who lost the handle and picked up by Ann Lopez. And now she is called for a traveling violation. Now Jared Gilbert will sub again. Lily Pridemore back in there, 5'10 sophomore. Also Lily Saliba, 5-foot freshman, entering the lineup. Peyton Blanton, the 5'7 sophomore, in there as well. Off the inbounds, it comes into Pridemore, back to Jenna Hall. Baseline 10-footer is good. So Jenna Hall on the board with her first basket. Orleans scored the first 18 before giving up a field goal. Now they've scored 10 straight, lead at 28-2 with 3.5 minutes to go. Bad pass again. Too much pressure. Nicole Tucker lost it. Here's Peyton Blanton on the other end, scooping one up with a right-handed layup. Peyton has her fifth point. now 30-2. Owen on the other end. High post, it comes to McCoy. Off now to Tucker, lost the handle, it goes into the backcourt. That'll be an over and back violation.
22 turnovers against Christian Academy already.
In almost 13 minutes. Wow. 3-2 zone again by Christian Academy. As Blanton on the high post, try to go to Pridemore, stolen away by Owen. Ashland on the break to the other end. Tries to feed it in low, had it knocked away. Here's Lily Saliba taking it all the way to the goal, scooping it up and in. Nice move by Lily Saliba, getting the steal and taking it all the way to the other end.
Always nice to get a freshman involved and get right. her in the scoring column there.
32-2. Owen has it on the left wing, backs it out to near center court, picks up the dribble, hands it off now to Lopez. Lopez drives, picks up the dribble at the foul line, drawing the double team, lost it, got it back. She can dribble again. It was touched down the high post to McCoy, who just blindly flings up a shot way off target. Here's Hall back the other way, leaves it off for Blanton and now to Saliba. Works it over to Haley Powell. Cut off along the baseline. In low to Lily Pridemore. Her shot would not go. Ball being tipped around. And it should be Orleans basketball. Oh. I was wondering why Christian Academy didn't chase after the ball, but it's going to be their basketball at any rate with a minute 51 remaining here in the opening half. At least things moving along pretty fast. Haven't had a lot of fouls. There's Saliba knocking the ball away from Ashlyn Owen. She's averaging 8 a game. As we said, the team only averages 12. They've scored 13, 11, and 12 in their three games thus far. So, in the meantime, they're giving up 70 points a game. Here's McCoy, and again, allowing a tie-up as they went in on the high post, and three Orleans players converged on her.
You like to see that when the ball goes in the post. You trap out of the post and recover. And good job tying it by Peyton Blanton, tie it up there.
Three-point try by Owen is blocked. And here comes Orleans quickly into the front court. Blanton tried to go in low. It's knocked away. Loose ball, and it's McCoy that picked it up now for Christian Academy. Into the front court, lost the handle. Now we're going to get a reach-in foul here on Lily Saliba. Her first, just the second. So Christian Academy a long way away from getting into the bonus.
Got Brooklyn Underwood in the game as well. Another freshman.
Out front, Tucker with the basketball, tried to go on the high post to McCoy. It's knocked away as Orleans playing a 2-3 zone right now, and that pass just isn't going to work. Final minute of the first half to the baseline, Underwood, lost the handle, and she brought the ball down and got tied up. So that will keep the basketball with Orleans. Jenna Hall will look to get it in. Goes to Peyton Blant, moves it around now to Saliba. Off now to Underwood, feeds it in low to Pridemore, backs away and puts it off the glass. Two more. Boy, what a job the sophomore is doing, posting up down low.
It's just not. I coached her in elementary and some things. Just not see the improvement that she's made over the years, and she's really gotten strong underneath the basket.
Lopez looks to get rid of it. Off now to Owen. At the point, back over to Lopez. Launches a three. That was partially blocked. And Jenna Hall comes out of there with it, but foot was on the end line, so Christian Academy will get one more crack at it perhaps here before halftime. Oh, they didn't throw to anybody in particular. Picked up by Lily Saliba all the way down court, and nobody for Christian Academy there. And boy, that is about as easy a basket as you're going to get. 36-2 now, final 10 seconds. There goes Owen down the lane, pulls up, misses the shot, rebound to Underwood, 4 seconds to go. Brooklyn into the front court, stop and will not get the shot off before we come to the end of this first half of play. To say the least, Orleans has dominated the action. From the varsity all the way down to the elementary grades, your friends at Scott Doherty Trucking are proud to salute each student athlete for their hard work and dedication in continuing the legacy of excellence that is Lady Bulldogs basketball. Good luck all season long from everyone at Scott Doherty Trucking in Orleans, keeping America's economy on the move. We've reached halftime here at Christian Academy in New Albany. And after two periods of play on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, it is the Lady Bulldogs 36 and the Lady Warriors 2. We'll start our halftime activities when we come back. You're listening to Orleans Girls Basketball.
Are you on our VIP list? If you're not, you should be. Hi, I'm JC Watson with Super Clean Car Wash. By texting the word Super Clean to 31996, you can join our list to receive exclusive text offers for our car wash. Every so often, we will text you an offer code that can be used at any of our four convenient locations. Visit us today in Orleans, Bedford, Jasper, and Salem. Super Clean Car Wash. It's not clean till it's super clean.
Don't think your old furnace can take another winter? Pipe Dreams Incorporated in Bedford to the rescue. Owner Nick Blanton and his staff at Pipe Dreams Incorporated are ready to install for you a new energy-efficient Rood furnace. They'll come out and give you a free estimate to determine what unit will work best and then help you choose the right plan, including financing options. Make your home a comfortable place to live again with a new furnace from Pipe Dreams Incorporated. Your Rood heating and cooling dealer in Bedford. Call 279-9594. Pipe Dreams Incorporated is a proud supporter of girls' sports in Orleans and the surrounding communities.
When it comes to buying insurance, you want a company that will take the guesswork out of finding the proper coverage at premiums that are affordable. At the Busick Insurance Agency in Orleans, your auto owner's agent, they'll work with you to determine the right amount of coverage. To get the best protection for home, health, auto, life, and business, call Patton or Brett Busick or Josh Crocker or Richard Grace at the Busick Insurance Agency, your auto owner's agent on East Jefferson Street in Orleans at 865-2626. Busick Insurance, a proud supporter of Orleans Bulldog Sports.
All Brothers Transportation in Orleans, a name that has stood for dependability for many years, is proud to continue their support of the Orleans Bulldogs and to the many events and activities of the school and the community as well. They realize the importance athletics have on our young people in building character and to adults in experiencing the thrill of high school sports. Hall Brothers Transportation has been serving the shipping needs of much of the Midwest, providing the link to keep businesses strong and our area's economy growing.
Hall Brothers Transportation, Highway 37 in Orleans, serving the area since 1979.
Before we start our halftime activities from Christian Academy High School in New Albany, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
You're listening to the 6,000-watt sports voice of the Valley, WFLQ, French Lick, Indiana.
Super freak. The girls are super freak. Through 16 minutes, Lady Bulldogs showing their mastery of this rebuilding Christian Academy program. 17 in the opening quarter for the Lady Bulldogs, 19 in quarter number two. Meanwhile, holding CAI to just one field goal at this juncture. A lot of young ladies get an opportunity to showcase their skills, and they are certainly making the most of it. As we look at the scoring, it is Sheridan Robbins leading the way. 7 of her 9 points coming in that second quarter. Right behind her is Haley Powell with 8, although Haley has struggled a bit at the foul line, missing on all 4 of her tries. Lily Pridemore has really been a force in the first half. She has 3 field goals and 6 points. 5 from Peyton Blanton, 2 field goals, and she also converted a traditional 3-point play. Lily Saliba, the freshman, has come in and impressed. 2 field goals for a total of 4. Sydney Moon, a basket for 2. Jenna Hall, likewise, a basket for 2. Only Audrey Elrod and Jack Gerken, who started, have not scored, along with Brooklyn Underwood, who has come off the bench for Orleans. For Christian Academy, the only person that has scored thus far, Ashlyn Owen. He had a basket early on in that second quarter. And that has been the extent of the scoring. Two fouls on Aaron Stensrud. She played the first 3 minutes and has sat out since that time. Orleans only whistled for two fouls in those first two periods of play. 17-0 Orleans after one. They outscore Christian Academy 19-2 in the second quarter, and they lead here at the break on the Busick Insurance scoreboard at 36-2. We'll take a quick timeout. Aaron Freed will look at our first half statistics when we return. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
You've worked hard to build and protect your estate throughout your lifetime. Enjoy the confidence that comes from knowing all you've worked for may be preserved for your heirs. Please call Jamie Sullivan, Senior Vice President of Investments of Sullivan Financial Consulting of Raymond James, located in Mitchell, at 849-2670. Jamie can help design a comprehensive plan suited for your family's future financial needs. Call Jamie Sullivan today at 849-2670. Raymond James & Associates Incorporated, member New York Stock Exchange, SIPC.
Orange County REMC is now offering you affordable protection for your home. Home security systems are available for members and non-members and will provide protection from fire, carbon monoxide, and theft. These systems are continuously monitored so you'll have a peace of mind whether you're at home, work, or on vacation. You might even qualify for a discount on your homeowner's premium. Packages starting at $199 with monitoring starting at $2495. For more information on these home services, call Orange County REMC at 812-865-2229.
Planet Insurance in Orleans is serious about protecting you and your interests. They represent Hastings Mutual. And Landis is ready to satisfy your auto, home, farm, business, or other insurance needs. Hastings Mutual and Landis together providing Midwestern value since 1885. Call the Landis Agency in Orleans at 865-4792. Halftime at Christian Academy High School in New Albany. All Lady Bulldogs thus far. They're up 36-2. And I'm sure, Aaron, that the statistical part of things are as one-sided as what they are on the scoreboard.
Well, Orleans had a good second quarter there as they shot several layups, as we talked about, from turnovers and defense. And so we talked about what a slow start they got off to shooting the basketball, even though they were good looks. They finished up the quarter at 52%. Finished up the half at 52% for the halftime. No three pointers, but that's really in this game. You really, with the 3-2 zone, you're trying to get the ball inside anyway. An area of concern for anybody or for me and any coach, that 2 of 7 from the free throw line, those are free 3 points, and you're not taking advantage of them. So if you're going to talk about something at halftime, 2 of 7 at the foul line is something that probably Coach Gilbert I'll be talking about that. They had 17 total rebounds, 8 on the offensive end, 8 turnovers for Orleans in the half, which some of that was at the beginning, just a slow start. And then that is all I had for the that's all I had for the Orleans stats in the first half. For Christian Academy, with 2 points at the half, they shot 13% in the for the half, 1 of 8. They had 1 of 4 in the second quarter for 25%. Just not many shots. They said they had 7 rebounds, 1 offensive rebound, 6 defensive rebounds. But the key to the game and the story of the game is Christian Academy has 26 turnovers, and those have led to many baskets for the Orleans Bulldogs.
From the varsity all the way down to the elementary grades, your friends at Scott Doherty Trucking are proud to salute each student-athlete for their hard work and dedication in continuing the legacy of excellence that is Lady Bulldogs basketball. Good luck all season long from everyone at Scott Doherty Trucking in Orleans, keeping America's economy on the move. Moments away from the start of the second half, it's all Orleans. They're up 36-2 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. We'll return to Christian Academy in New Albany after this timeout.
Are you on our VIP list? If you're not, you should be. Hi, I'm JC Watson with Super Clean Car Wash. By texting the word Super Clean to 31996, you can join our list to receive exclusive text offers for our car wash. Every so often, we will text you an offer code that can be used at any of our four convenient locations. Visit us today in Orleans, Bedford, Jasper, and Salem. Super Clean Car Wash. It's not clean till it's super clean.
Don't think your old furnace can take another winter? Pipe Dreams Incorporated in Bedford to the rescue. Owner Nick Blanton and his staff at Pipe Dreams Incorporated are ready to install for you a new energy efficient Rood furnace. They'll come out and give you a free estimate to determine what unit will work best and then help you choose the right plan, including financing options. Make your home a comfortable place to live again with a new furnace from Pipe Dreams Incorporated, your Rood heating and cooling dealer in Bedford. Call 279-9594. Pipe Dreams Incorporated, a proud supporter of girls' sports in Orleans and the surrounding communities.
Lady Warriors with the ball to start the second half. They're in white. Orleans is in black. Orleans will go left to right here in this second half of play. Out front is Ashlyn Owen, the freshman. Works it around now to Ann Lopez. Will launch a three-pointer. Would not go. And a tie-up on the ensuing rebound as Powell and Stentru tie one another up, and this time the arrow will give it to the Lady Bulldogs.
If I'm Coach Gilbert, I'm talking about the score being 0-0, and he's coming out and playing hard and trying to do the things that we talked about in the locker room at the start of the game.
Gerken works it around now to Audrey Elrod and low to Moon, kicks it out to Gerken, and we're going to get a 3-second violation here. Well, that's Dick Kinoy. We probably had at least a half a dozen three-second calls in Saturday's Rock Creek Springs Valley game, and how that game goes by that he doesn't like to.
I think in that case, that was
those people that are camping in the paint.
That was a good call because he was in there a while.
Yeah. Here's a drive by McCoy. Works it around now to Estes. Now to McCoy. Works it around to Lopez. At the corner, it is McCoy off now for a three-point try. That is good by Ashlyn Owen as she banked that one off the glass and in. So a thrill for the Lady Warrior fans. They're not used to seeing their team score much. Oh, nice baseline move. Sydney Moon takes it in, missed it, got her own rebound, kicks it back to Robin. She penetrates, kicks it free throw line to Haley Powell, who throws it down the lane, missed it, rebound Sheridan Robbins. One dribble back up, no good. But another CAI foul will put Sheridan back to the stripe. Ella McCoy picks up the foul. That'll be her second, the first by either team here in the half. Orleans as a team shoots 60%, but as Aaron said, just 29% thus far, and that will improve as Sheridan becomes our first double-figure scorer with her 10th point. As she knocks that one in. And the second one on its way. Good rotation. Same result. So 11 for Sheridan, 38-5 in favor of Orleans. I doubt many of these kids know that Christian Academy's low water mark in these first three games is 11, but I'm sure they'll do their best to try to keep them under that, but we'll see how it goes. There's a steal by Haley Powell on the entry pass. That led to Sydney Moon ahead to a breaking Sheridan Robbins, who takes it in for an easy two. Good job by the Lady Bulldogs to get the steal and playing heads-up ball. And Sydney saw Sheridan down court, who now has 13 in the contest, and it's 40-5 Orleans. Lopez works it around now to McCoy out between the circles. High post to Stensrud. Turns around against Haley Powell, looks to drive it on her, but reaching in and stealing it is Sheridan Robbins. She's got Sydney Moon down court, but Sheridan's pass sails over her head and out of bounds. Those kind of turnovers, though, you can kind of live with. It was a hustle play.
Absolutely, it was a hustle play. She's looking ahead. It's the right play. She just didn't make it correctly.
Sure. There goes Estes all the way down the lane, puts up the runner, no good, but does draw the foul.
That's a foul you just can't have. You, I mean, we just need to slide over there and get and step in front of somebody. That's just that's not a good foul there.
Right. Sydney Moon calls for the foul, her first. First on Orleans in the half. Playing it in from the baseline is Estes to Lopez. sealed off by Elrod, looking to get rid of it, and it's through the hands of Stens Roof, all not free, and Jack Durkin comes out of there with it. Heading out to Sheridan, Robbins beats it in low to Sydney Moon, who scoops it up, missed it. Audrey Elrod the rebound, out of the wing now to Robbins. Sheridan fakes the three, top of the key to Gherkin. Jack's three, good. So the junior breaks into the scoring column as she knocks down the first triple of the night for the Lady Dogs. And the lead continues to grow. It's 43-5, and another timeout here called by Chris Jefferson and Christian Academy. 5:01 to go, third quarter, as the Lady Bulldogs continue to dominate play here at Christian Academy in New Albany. They lead 43-5 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. Back with more Lady Bulldogs basketball in just a moment.
When it comes to buying insurance, you want a company that will take the guesswork out of finding the proper coverage at premiums that are affordable. At the Busick Insurance Agency in Orleans, your auto owner's agent, they'll work with you to determine the right amount of coverage. To get the best protection for home, health, auto, life, and business, call Patton or Brett Busick or Josh Crocker or Richard Grace at the Busick Insurance Agency, your auto owner's agent on East Jefferson Street in Orleans at 865-2626. Busick Insurance, a proud supporter of Orleans Bulldog Sports.
Landis Insurance in Orleans is serious about protecting you and your interests. They represent Hastings Mutual. And Landis is ready to satisfy your auto, home, farm, business, or other insurance needs. Hastings Mutual and Landis, together providing Midwestern value since 1885. Call the Landis Agency in Orleans at 865-4792. 5:01 left in this one. Orleans on a 7-3 run here in the third quarter. Their lead is 38 now. McCoy has it at the free throw line, drives it in, lost the handle, and they're going to say it is last touched by Orleans. Sometimes got to be a lot of frustration if you're Coach Chris Jefferson.
Yep.
Have a bunch of good kids, and they're doing their best to learn. It just takes a lot of time. They probably don't have a lot of experience.
That's why coaches that get gray hair or they don't have any hair like me.
Right. I would say with your less fundamentally sound teams, you do more coaching than you do with the ones that have all sorts of natural talent.
That's absolutely correct.
Lopez did a nice move, spun back the other way, but missed the 15-footer, almost got it to go. And they're going to call a foul here. And Ella McCoy is going to pick up the foul. That'll be her third.
Let's see if Haley Powell can get a touch here on the block.
4:25 to go, third quarter. Robbins in low. Haley for the catch and lay in. All she did was flash down on the block. Sheridan hit her perfectly, and now Haley Powell is in double figures with her 10th point of the contest. 45-5 now, nearing the halfway point of the third quarter. Here's Lopez at the point, calling out the play. Off the screen, launches a three, missed it badly. Haley Powell, another rebound. I have a feeling here these starters are not going to be in for too much longer. Nice feed to Audrey Elrod, cutting down the lane, and she got whacked on the arm. Good job there by Jack to hit a cutting Audrey Elrod. Aaron Stentrew, the foul, her third, and hard to believe Audrey Elrod, who is playing, exceptional basketball has not scored. But
yeah, she's had a really good start to her senior year. She's done a really nice job.
And she does break into the scoring column as she drops in the free one. Casey Souter, the 5'8 sophomore, back in for Christian Academy. And Peyton Blanton returning now for Orleans. Second free throw by Audrey is short. We're going to get a lane violation here. I think somebody for Christian Academy, I think it was Stensrud, jumped in the lane a tad bit too soon. So let's see if Audrey can make the most of her opportunity. And she does. So after going 2-for-7 from the line in the first half, Orleans has converted all four of their foul shots, so maybe that was a point of emphasis from Coach Gilbert the locker room at halftime.
I figured it might be.
Working the weave out along the perimeter is Christian Academy. There's a ball batted away. Audrey Elrod getting the bat on the pass, but could not keep it in play as it sails out of bounds here on the near side. Owen out on the floor with Lopez. Stentrud. There goes Owen into the lane. Lost the handle. Got it back. Now the ball is loose again, and now we'll have a tie-up again, and it will stay with Christian Academy. Orleans by 42. 3:22 to go here in this third quarter of play from New Albany. And the ball knocked away. Picked up by Stentrud. Throws up the runner. Would not go. Oh, Orleans did not hustle. Now they do come up with a steal, however. Here comes Robbins back the other way. 3-on-1. Hook pass, weak side to Audrey Elrod, who missed it. But Peyton Blanton tries to go back up and will draw another foul. And this one will go on Ann Lopez. Her first. And Peyton to the line to shoot a couple. And then these second, third chance opportunities for Orleans that they're making the most of. As first free throw by Peyton is good. That's her sixth point of the contest. 48-5. And in and out with that one and stand through the rebound. Didn't want to jinx Peyton. She still missed anyway. It's first miss after hitting five in a row for Orleans here in the quarter. Lopez drives, hands off to Stentrud on the wing. Drives, pulls up for a 10-footer, couldn't get it to go. One and done again as Orleans doing a good job of blocking out. Blanton off now to Robbins. Down the lane she goes. Scoops it up for the right hand for an easy two.
Sheridan's going to be a nice player for Orleans. Just a sophomore, but she looks really comfortable out there.
Going to be. She already is, I think.
Well, it's going to be exciting to watch her in the next couple of years.
So much better.
Absolutely.
Too. You're right. 50-5 now, 15 now for Sheridan. Losing the ball, but picking it up near the sideline is Ann Lopez. Hands it off now to Owen. Ashlyn, no, bad pass. Anticipating that was Sheridan, and she'll take it to the other end for an easy two again. 8 in the period now for Sheridan Robbins. And with 2:05 to go here in the third quarter, it is 52-5. Owen walks it into the front court. High post now to Lopez. On the dribble, out along the perimeter. Thought about the three. Hands it over to Souter. Looks for somewhere to go. Trying to go inside instead to Lopez. He'll heave up a three out of the corner, would not go, and the rebound yanked out of there by Jack Gerken. Off now to Blanton, Orleans running, Elrod, left wing, back up top now to Blanton, moves it around now to Robbins. Sheridan dribbles it to the top of the circle to Blanton, high post to Powell, who roars it down the lane, scooped it up, missed it, got her own rebound, missed it, but gets hacked on the arm, and more free throws upcoming here as Orleans continues to get offensive rebound. After offensive rebound.
Very aggressive move by Haley. But what I like about Haley is she's really good about hitting the boards. I mean, she's a very good offensive rebounder. Got her own that time.
And Haley continuing to struggle at the line. 47% on the year. But she is now 0-for-5 at the stripe. Sydney Moon comes back in. Out will go Audrey Elrod. And that one rolled off the rim, no good. Rebound, Robbins back up, no good. Nobody wants the rebound. Robbins has it. She loses it. Finally, it is picked up by Estes. Minute 14 to go. There goes Lopez all the way to the left baseline. Brings it back out. Stops. Looks to hand it off now to Owen. Goes back to Lopez. She'll dribble it to the foul line. Jumps it off to Souter. High post to Stentrud, who had the ball knocked away again. Active hands here for Orleans. Under a minute to go, third quarter. Gerken between the circles, moves it around now to Blant. Peyton, top of the arc to Robbins, who takes one dribble, launches from downtown, would not go. And this time, Stentrud outfights Haley Powell for the board. Into the front court comes Lopez. Slides it right, hands it off now to Owen. Owen takes it between the circles, now drives it on Blanton. Tries to throw it up and had it blocked away and out of bounds. Ashton Neighbors back in. Out will go Aaron Stensrud. Estes will trigger it in underneath the basket for Christian Academy. Still looking, gets it in now to Neighbors. Turns, clears it away now to Souter out beyond the arc. Bounces away to Neighbors again. Down to 12 seconds to go in the quarter. Owen between the circles, clears it away to Lopez. Not sure if CAI knows how much time is left. 4 seconds to go, three, and the ball knocked out of bounds by Haley Powell. So Lady Warriors will have 2 seconds to try to get a shot off before the end of the third quarter. Doing so is Estes. It comes into Lopez, who leaves one up, nearly banked that one in from the right corner. But at the end of three on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, Orleans continues to flex their muscle. They lead Christian Academy 52-5. We'll be back with the fourth quarter in a moment. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
Hub Brothers Transportation in Orleans, a name that has stood for dependability for many years, is proud to continue their support of the Orleans Bulldogs and to the many events and activities of the school and the community as well. They realize the importance athletics have on our young people in building character and to adults in experiencing the thrill of high school sports. Hub Brothers Transportation has been serving the shipping needs of much of the Midwest, providing the link to keep businesses strong and our area's economy growing.
Hub Brothers Transportation, Highway 37 in Orleans, serving the area since 1979.
You've worked hard to build to protect your estate throughout your lifetime. Enjoy the confidence that comes from knowing all you've worked for may be preserved for your heirs. Please call Jamie Sullivan, Senior Vice President of Investments of Sullivan Financial Consulting of Raymond James, located in Mitchell at 849-2670. Jamie can help design a comprehensive plan suited for your family's future financial needs. Call Jamie Sullivan today at 849-2670. Raymond James and Associates Incorporated, member New York Stock Exchange, SIPC.
With Aaron Freed, Mike Hamilton at Christian Academy in New Albany, as Christian Academy late getting on the floor, officials can put the ball down, and that's exactly what they did. Threw it into Brooklyn Underwood. She had a startled look on her face, and they said, go to the basket. She took it in and laid it up and in.
I'm laughing because nobody had to tell me that. I needed to shoot it. I didn't play much, but I got my shots up.
Yeah. So Brooklyn Underwood becomes the 10th player to score. Make that the 9th player. No, I was right. 10th player to score. Off the inbounds, long shot missed here by Ann Lopez. Rebound to Lily Saliba. So all new faces in there right now for Orleans. And by that I mean their starters. These have already played. Here's Underwood. Works it in low to Lily Pridemore. Missed it. Got her own rebound. Put it back up and in. 8 points now for Lily Pridemore. 56-5 here in the first minute of this fourth quarter. Into the front court comes Lopez, drives it, hands off to Neighbors, top of the key to Owen. Owen off the McCoy screen to the baseline, puts it up from 10, left that one short. Peyton Blanton the rebound now. Peyton slows it down as she gets to the end of the front court, into the 3-2 zone, cross-courts it to Underwood. Clears it away now to Saliba. Along the perimeter, they swing it down to Jenna Hall. In low to Lily Pridemore, who just laid it up and in for two more.
Lily just keeps getting better and better.
Yep. Boy, this is a career moment for this young lady. 10 now for Lily Pridemore. It's 58-5. Neighbors out along the perimeter, jumps it off now to Owen. Moves it over on the right side to Lopez. Slides off the screen. Launches from 16. Couldn't get it to go. And Lily Saliba the rebound. Quickly into the front court. Waits for traffic to clear. Slows it down. Now works it over to Blanton. Peyton goes back to Saliba. Over to Underwood. Left side. Brooklyn had the pass tip. But Blanton's got it. Over now to Jenna Hall. In low to Pridemore. Turns. Missed the shot this time. Good try, though, as only Pridemore continuing to be active inside. Here's Lopez the other way. Little crossover move off now to Neighbors. Takes it to the top of the circle and hands off to Owen. Ball batted away and stolen by Brooklyn Underwood. She's on the break to the other end, and she's got two more. Brooklyn Underwood's got four. And it's now 60-5. With 5:22 remaining.
Brooklyn had a nice volleyball year for the Bulldogs as well. Another good freshman for Orleans.
Owen works it around now to Neighbors. Beats it in low to McCoy. Takes one dribble and air ball that one. And out of bounds. You know, one thing you can say for Christian Academy, they are trying to run some semblance of an offense.
They're trying.
The execution is just not quite there. And
they're still playing hard.
Mm-hmm.
Elizabeth Tabor checked in for Orleans, number 33.
All right, so more new faces.
Nice
Orleans Pridemore down on the post. It's banked home two more.
Nice pass from Elizabeth Tabor there, but nice bounce pass, and Lily was able to drop step and score.
12 now for Lily Pridemore. It's 62-5. Here's Owen off the screen. Can't get the shot off. Reverses the dribble on the baseline. Throws up the runner, no good. Ball being tapped around. Pridemore the rebound. This is Faber, a 5'5 sophomore out there on the court. And Jared Gilbert's going to go deeper to his bench now. Faber that time called for a travel. Hesitated as she caught the ball and moved her foot. That'll be a turnover. Not many tonight. Four. Orleans. As we see Riley Reed, a 5'5 sophomore, check into the lineup now for Orleans. And Stensrud returning as well.
I have Orleans for 10 turnovers tonight, Mike.
57-point advantage for the Lady Bulldogs. Here's a lob in low to Stensrud. Puts it up from 10 and banks it off the glass and in. So the first points of the fourth quarter for Christian Academy. 62-7 now as we're halfway through the final quarter. Saliba picks up the dribble and tries to kick it down to the corner, and it's over the head of Tabor and out of bounds. From the varsity all the way down to the elementary grades, your friends at Sky Doherty Trucking are proud to salute each student athlete for their hard work and dedication in continuing the legacy of excellence that is Lady Bulldogs basketball. Good luck all season long from everyone at Scott Doherty Trucking in Orleans, keeping America's economy on the move. McCoy misses a short jumper for Christian Academy. Back comes Orleans now. Saliba feeds it over here to Reed. Hands off to Underwood. Back in low to Saliba under heavy traffic.
Pass.
Nice weak side pass off to Riley Reed, who puts it up and in. Good heads-up play that time by the freshman. Lily Saliba will get a nice assist. And Riley Reed, her first career points. It's now 64-7. Oh, almost getting one to go with Stensrud. And she turned to the glass, couldn't get it to go. And we'll get a timeout called here by Jared Gilbert.
He's going to try to get some kids in, Mike.
Just wanted to get a couple more in there. So Brooklyn Cromwell will come in now for Orleans.
Brooklyn is a very good golfer for Orleans. She's been to the regional the last couple of years. I try to get her to give me pointers at lunch, but she's a lot better than I. She can't help me.
She's probably going to charge you for them. I would.
Yeah, well, I'm still not very good, but she is very good. Been to the regional the last 2 years in golf.
Yes.
Then the only Alabama fan I know in Orleans, Alabama football fan, so.
Yeah, we won't hold that against her, I guess.
Well, I can't really talk about IU football when she's talking about Alabama, so there you go.
Big difference there, right?
Absolutely. And I hate to admit that, but it's very true.
All right, so Brooklyn in there, the 5'1 senior, and then also to complete everything out, Hannah Shaw is in there as well. And she just got called for a traveling violation. Hannah, a 5'4 junior.
She, it's good to see Hannah playing again. She plays on our softball team. She didn't play last year because of her knee problems, but I'm glad she's back playing again.
Bob in low now to Stenterud. That's a triple team, and we're going to get a foul here called on Orleans. And so mail Tabor for the foul. Elizabeth with her first. Just the second team foul. Ball comes into Lopez. Drives it to the foul line, jumps it off to McCoy. Ella McCoy on the dribble, hands it off now to Owen. Ashlyn Owen drives it down the lane. And just to hand it off to Lopez, he'll heave up a three and clangs off the back iron and hits the guy wire above the basket. So chance here for Orleans to hold Christian Academy to single digits. Been a fun night here as the Lady Bulldogs will improve to 4-1. Christian Academy will drop to 0-4. With the basketball is Cromwell off the Tabor, hands it off now to Underwood, drives it down the lane. They're going to call her for a palming violation. Well, I'll tell you what, in a situation like this, I'd be looking to try to get the ball to Brooklyn Cromwell as a senior.
Let her score?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I can get on the board here.
Like to see that. It's good to see these freshmen, sophomores getting a chance, and juniors getting their chance to play.
Right. Owen out along the perimeter, works it around now to Stenterud. On the dribble, lobs it in low to McCoy, who puts it up from 10 and banks it in. Ella McCoy, boy, you almost just want to cheer for Christian Academy. You know, it's been a tough year for them, so why not? 64-9 now, so they do have a chance. It's Underwood all the way to the goal, had it stuffed, and then a rebound putback attempt there by Anna Shaw, sails over the backboard and out of bounds. So with a minute 22 left on the Busick Insurance scoreboard, a 55-point Orleans lead. We'll see if Christian Academy can break it into double digits. Here's Lopez, drives it left, around her defender, drives in and draws the two-shot foul. As the ball wedges between the backboard and rim, one of the officials tried to jump up and dislodge it, couldn't. We actually had that in Saturday's game, too. So these officials, I swear, the same things happened to them or something. Foul call on Brooklyn Underwood is her first. And going to the free throw line is Ann Lopez. These will be the first free throws of the night shot by Christian Academy. Lopez takes her time, fires this one up, and couldn't get the bounce. So another opportunity here with a minute 9 remaining. Spins it in her hand, drops it, fires it up, and couldn't get it to go, and the rebound yanked out of there now by Anna Shaw. She'll take it into the front court herself, beats it over on the right side to Brooklyn Cromwell, and it's through her hands and out of bounds with exactly 1 minute remaining. We'll say the game seems like it's gone pretty fast, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just about an hour and 15 minutes. We'll take that.
Yeah.
Here's Lopez. They leave her open. She'll launch. Couldn't get it to go. Rebound run down by Lopez. She'll take it into lane. Pull up for a 10-footer. No good. Rebound. Stenzroot couldn't get that one to go. And then Orleans knocks it out of bounds. It's off of Shaw. So, again, Christian Academy with golden opportunities to try to break the double-digit plateau. They'll get another shot here with 42 seconds to go as it comes into Stenzroot. Looks Lopez out of the corner for three on the rim and off. Rebound Stenterud back up, and she draws the foul. It'll be a non-shooting foul, but it'll still be out of bounds to Christian Academy as the foul will go on Riley Reed. So Christian Academy with 34 seconds remaining will put it in play. Tucker looking to get it in underneath. Oh, they tried to go in to Stenterud, and it bounced back to Tucker, who hadn't gotten herself back in bounds yet. So now with a half minute to go, Orleans by 55. That's moved by Underwood, hands it off now to Tabor. Tabor drives it to the baseline, beats it in low to Shaw, who missed that one. Rebound fought for, and we'll have a held ball situation. And the arrow will keep it to Orleans. So it looks like now, unless something major happens, Orleans is going to hold Christian Academy to under 10 points. Off it comes into Shaw. Shot up is blocked away by Christian Academy. And with 11 seconds left, one more opportunity here for Orleans. Let's see if they can maybe get Brooklyn Cromwell open, the senior, to get an opportunity, at least to get a shot off. Comes into Shaw, though, her 10-footer is good. That should do it. As Anna Shaw with her fourth point of the contest. 1 second to go, and, oh, Ashlyn Owen nearly did it. Her had about a 30-footer from the volleyball spiking line and just would not go, and that will do it for this one. Orleans had a slow start. They only had 2 points through the first 3.5 minutes, but finally got things generated, and they cruised to an easy victory here tonight. They're now 4-1 on the year, while Christian Academy drops to 0-4. Landis Insurance in Orleans is serious about protecting you and your interests. They represent Hastings Mutual, and Landis is ready to satisfy your auto, home, farm, business, or other insurance needs. Hastings Mutual and Landis together, providing Midwestern value since 1885, call the Landis Agency in Orleans at 865-4792. We'll be back to recap all of tonight's action in a moment. The final score here this evening from Christian Academy High School in New Albany. On the Music Insurance Scoreboard, Orleans 66 and Christian Academy of Indiana 9. You're listening to Orleans Girls Basketball.
Orange County REMC is now offering you affordable protection for your home. Home security systems are available for members and non-members and will provide protection from fire, carbon monoxide, and theft. These systems are continuously monitored so you'll have a peace of mind whether you're at home, work, or on vacation. You might even qualify for a discount on your homeowner's premium. Packages starting at $199 with monitoring starting at $24.95. For more information on these home services, call Orange County REMC at 812-865-2229.
Are you on our VIP list? If you're not, you should be. Hi, I'm JC Watson with Super Clean Car Wash. By texting the word Super Clean to 31996, you can join our list to receive exclusive text offers for our car wash. Every so often, we will text you an offer code that can be used at any of our 4 convenient locations. Visit us today in Orleans, Bedford, Jasper, and Salem. Super don't Clean think Car Wash. It's not clean till it's super clean.
Don't think your old furnace can take another winter? Pipe Dreams Incorporated in Bedford to the rescue. Owner Nick Blanton and his staff at Pipe Dreams Incorporated are ready to install for you a new energy-efficient Rood furnace. They'll come out and give you a free estimate to determine what unit will work best and then help you choose the right plan, including financing options. Make your home a comfortable place to live again with a new furnace from Pipe Dreams Incorporated. Your Rood heating and cooling dealer in Bedford. Call 279-9594. Pipe Dreams Incorporated, a proud supporter of girls' sports in Orleans and the surrounding communities.
When it comes to buying insurance, you want a company that will take the guesswork out of finding the proper coverage at premiums that are affordable. At the Buzik Insurance Agency in Orleans, your auto owner's agent, they'll work with you to determine the right amount of coverage. To get the best protection for home, health, auto, life, and business, call Patton or Brett Buzik or Josh Crocker or Richard Grace at the Buzik Insurance Agency, your auto owner's agent on East Jefferson Street in Orleans at 865-2626. Buzik Insurance, a proud supporter of Orleans Bulldog Sports.
Hall Brothers Transportation in Orleans, a name that has stood for dependability for many years, is proud to continue their support of the Orleans Bulldogs and to the many events and activities of the school and the community as well. They realize the importance athletics have on our young people in building character and to adults in experiencing the thrill of high school sports. Hall Brothers Transportation has been serving the shipping needs of much of the Midwest, providing the link to keep businesses strong and our area's economy growing.
Hall Brothers Transportation, Highway 37 in Orleans, serving the area since 1979.
The From the varsity all the way down to the elementary grades, your friends at Scott Doherty Trucking are proud to salute these student-athletes for their hard work and dedication in continuing the legacy of excellence that is Lady Bulldogs basketball. Good luck all season long from everyone at Scott Doherty Trucking in Orleans, keeping America's economy on the move. Now, the third game in 5 days for these Orleans girls, they really show little signs of wear and tear, but then again, they were not really tested too much tonight as they dominate play here against a undermanned Christian Academy team, 66-9, the final score on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. You kind of get a little bit of an feel or an effect there those first 3 or 4 minutes for Orleans, that in a quiet gym, yeah, making the long trip, having to get off the bus and try to get the blood flowing and crank things up, I guess. But finally, after about 3 or 4 minutes, the Lady Dogs were able to get things going.
Yeah, they got off to a slow start, but they were able to, once they got to that first basket, it kind of helped them get going. And I thought the bench, when he went to the bench and he brought Peyton and Lily in, I thought they came in and gave us 7 points there in that first quarter, and that got us going there, and they kind of rolled from there.
All right, let's bring in head coach Jared Gilbert. And coach, you were kind of looked like getting a little exasperated there in those first 3 or 4 minutes. Maybe it was a long bus ride, I'm not really sure, but the kids finally righted the ship and took care of things.
You know, it's one of those where we definitely came out and we didn't have the best focus, I thought, you know. And you're always concerned about that when you look at some of their scores and what they had done previous games, you know. Kids are kids. And
these kids aren't dumb. They see on the internet. They look at the scores and stuff.
Yeah, and it's hard to, you know, that's one of the hardest things to coach against. And you got to be a mature team to go into a game and keep that focus. And, you know, it was a long bus ride, and we got here, and, you know, it took probably a little longer than what it normally does. And then once we got here, it was somewhat concerning going in, because it's a different routine than we're normally used to with the OJV. And so there's a lot of things there, but, you know, obviously we still got to be ready to play. And once we finally got going there, we did some things that we wanted to do and kind of got going, but definitely something we want to avoid, we know, in the future, because usually you have a bad start like that and you put yourself in a pretty big hole.
I think perhaps the best thing that came out of this tonight, Coach, you got to play a lot of kids.
Yeah, we did. You know, we got to use our bench, and that's something we're always trying to lengthen as much as possible. And we feel like we can play 7-8 kids, and this is a great game for them to get some experience and get comfortable in the game. And you know, I thought our bench came in and did some nice things for us. Especially we have you know, you got Jenna Hall and Lily Primore that we feel like can play some minutes for us, and they're kind of going back and forth from JV to varsity. And they both went in, did some nice things, and made some baskets, played some pretty good defense, and made, you know, just some nice plays. So that's what we're looking forward to. That's something we feel like we will need in the future, so hopefully we can keep building on that.
Indeed, almost half your points were bench points tonight, 32 out of the 66, and you mentioned a couple of the key kids, you know, Lily down there on that block.
Right.
But give credit to her teammates. They were finding getting the ball to her.
They were. And, you know, I think a lot of the kids that were getting her the ball are the ones that play with her on a normal basis on the JV. And they realize, especially, you know, playing with her on the JV, that they need to find her. And she's a big reason why our JV scores when they do. And she's tough down there on the block and does some nice things. So I think we carry that and get some confidence and carry over into the varsity games as well.
Coach, I thought the two main reasons for the win tonight was the turnovers that you were able to force and the easy shots that you got from turnovers. But then I thought you did a nice job of rebounding and offensive rebounding and getting two and three chances at things before they stopped you. And I thought Haley Powell was a big key in that and getting the rebounds off the misses.
Yeah, she does such a good job. She goes after it 100%. You know, she definitely has that mindset that when that ball goes up, she's going to go rebound it and does a good job of pursuing it. So that's a big key and the reason why she gets so many rebounds on a normal basis. And definitely, you know, our pressure we thought would be key in being ready to play and turn them over. And we were able to do that early, even though we weren't making shots and things until we finally start going a little bit there. But yeah, for the most part, you know, we did those things really well. And something that, you know, we talked to the kids about, we didn't want to pressure too much there in the second half. Is one thing we said, I'm never going to tell you not to rebound or, you know, not to get loose balls and those things. You can keep playing hard in that area. You know, not maybe quite as much pressure in the second half. We wanted to see if we could just contain them and keep them in front of us without having to go out and pressure, because there's games and that's going to be our game plan, where we don't want to pressure because teams are going to be going by us. So that's kind of what we looked at in the second half, and we're able to do that pretty well.
And I know you well enough to know that when the second half started, you were looking up there and it was 0-0, and we're going to learn from this quarter and play this quarter out.
That's what we said. We can't look at the scoreboard and worry about that. You know, we just got to go out and play and make sure that we take care of business the second half and get better. And that's a whole trip down here, you know, kind of the talk yesterday. No matter what happens, we want to go down there, play good basketball, get better, and take care of business. And for the most part, we did that and did some nice things. Hopefully, we got a little better tonight.
This one's certainly a fun one, but boy, once you start back up on the schedule a week from Tuesday, and we talked a little bit on this last week on Sports Chat, boy, does the schedule toughen up, and I think that's an understatement. It starts with Ligoti, and Salem's going to be in that mix. Springs Valley's going to be in there here in the next week or two as well. So certainly kids are going to have to be ready, and while they had fun on this one, it's certainly going to be back to work tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. You know, we got a couple day of of practice here before we give them a couple days off and a little break, and we definitely realize that a big part of our schedule is coming up here before Christmas, and it's going to determine a lot of how our season, I think, shapes up and kind of what team that we can be, but also some very big conference games in there as well. So yeah, night in and night out, we're going to be tested, and hopefully we're up to the challenge, and I think our girls will. I think they're looking forward to it, and I know I am.
All right, Coach, thanks for the visit. Have a safe trip back. Hopefully the traffic, which kind of affected us, will not be as bad now as it was, a couple of hours or so, but you and the kids have a nice Thanksgiving. We'll talk to you next Monday night when we resume our sports chat. Our next game that we'll have, of course, you'll have a couple of midweek games, but we'll have you against Eastern Green coming up on December the 1st.
All right, that sounds good. Thanks a lot. Happy Thanksgiving to you guys, too.
All right. Jared Gilbert, the head coach of the Orleans Lady Bulldogs, joining us here after the contest as the Lady Bulldogs win it in convincing fashion by final count of 66-9 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. Let's bring in one of the ladies that contributed significantly to the victory here this evening, and that is sophomore Lily Pridemore. And Lily, this had to be fun tonight, wasn't it?
Yeah, it definitely was.
Talk a little bit about, you probably knew, I mean, you guys aren't dumb. You look, you see on the internet, you figure out how teams are and that type of thing, and you probably figured, hey, you know, if I play my cards right, hopefully I'll get a lot of playing time, and you certainly made the most of it. Just talk about what you were trying to do out there.
Well, I mean, I knew this was a good experience to get more,
playing time?
Yeah, like, and really show what I can do.
Sure.
I've been working on some new dribble moves this year, and this was, like, the perfect team to show those off. And
I thought you played a really good game around the basket. You were very aggressive on your rebounds. And then when you got the ball on the block, you put the ball in the basket. And I thought when you coming off the bench in the first quarter there, you gave us a good lift from your effort. So I thought you really had a nice game tonight.
Thank you.
This is a sophomore class that is very deep. I mean, you basically, well, start two sophomores and another one comes off the bench and then you come in as well. But just talk about this group in general. You guys have, I'm sure, had a lot of success all along the way. And now that you're here on varsity, really a chance to kind of display that even more.
Yeah, I feel like we all really play really well together. And not only as a team, but we're all like really good friends outside of school and in school. And especially on the court, we're good at talking with each other. And is a really good group of girls.
And I can say it's just a good group of kids. I know the assistant principal is not supposed to say that, but they're just a good group of kids.
Well, you probably know them a lot better than I do, so you can certainly vouch for them. Certainly, I think, Lily, that does make a difference, that chemistry out of the court. When your friend's off the court as well as mm-hmm. on, that certainly helps out. And when you guys work as hard as you do in yeah. practice and that type of thing. And that's just something that's going to get even better as the season goes along. I know you had a couple of seniors last year that you're
yeah.
going to miss,
right.
but a lot of new faces. And I know a lot of people vying for playing time, and I think Coach used 14 or 15 girls here
yeah.
Tonight. So everybody making everybody else mm-hmm. work a little bit here, and hopefully that's
yeah.
going to pay off as you guys continue to move along. Not just this season, but for especially you sophomores, heck, you still got
yeah.
a couple of years to go. You're not ready to start on that yet. You want to make
mm-hmm.
the most out of this season,
yeah.
certainly. But at times, too, I'm sure it can be a little bit of a learning process.
Yes, for sure, yeah.
All righty. Coach, it's going to be nice to you over the Thanksgiving holiday and kind
I
of
hope.
Let you guys stuff yourself a little bit. Probably on Friday he's going to run most
probably,
of that off.
Probably.
Now, what is the here's an interesting question, but are we practicing for Friday, or is it Black Friday for everybody with the shopping? Will we practice, or will we shop?
I'm not sure. I've never been Black Friday shopping, not
yeah.
gonna lie. My family never really did that.
I didn't know if we stayed away from that day, or that's just something that I wondered, well, if we would or not.
All righty, just talk a little bit about, we've talked with Coach Gilbert, and you probably have looked at the schedule. You know there's some really, really solid teams coming up. Ligoti, I think Salem moved up to second
mm-hmm.
in the polls. You've got your big rivalry game coming up here in a couple of weeks with Springs Valley and just some other solid squads. Paoli, Perry Central, all in there. So you guys are going to have to be ready to
oh,
play
yeah,
some
yeah.
good basketball.
For sure. We got some good teams coming up, though. So.
Talk a little bit about the preparation you're going to need to do to get ready for teams like that.
Lots of scrimmaging, that's for sure.
Hard play and
yeah.
keep working hard. All righty. Well, Lily, we appreciate you stopping by. Congratulations, 12-point effort.
Thank you.
Probably, maybe not quite as many, but I'll bet you had 7 or 8 rebounds as well to go along with that. A game I know you're going to remember, and I can just about guarantee you're going to have better games than this somewhere down the road.
Thank
this
you.
Year, next year, down the road, and in more meaningful games. Tonight, you didn't have to worry too much.
Yeah.
Got off to a big lead, took care of business, but certainly there'll be other games where those 12 points and ton of rebounds are really going to come in handy for you. So hurry up and get down. It's a long way back to Orleans. We don't want you missing the bus, but good luck as you continue
Thank
on
you.
For the rest of the
Thank
year.
Thank you.
Good job tonight, Lily.
Thank you.
Lily Pridemore, 12 points in the contest tonight. In fact, let's run through the scoring quickly here. For the Lady Bulldogs, Sheridan Robbins did lead the way. She had 17. Then came Lily Pridemore with the 12, including 6 there in that fourth quarter. The other double-figure scorer tonight, Haley Powell, she had 10. And I'm not trying to bring this up necessarily as a low point, but she was 0 for 6 at the free throw line, just stating a simple fact. I know she's
yeah.
a better free throw
well,
shooter than that, and it will get better.
They come in the mornings of their games, and they shoot free throws, and I know at practice they make them. Sometimes, you know, you just get in the streak where you're not making them. That's something that they'll work on, and she'll get better at as the year goes on.
Plenty of balance after that. Peyton Blanton off the bench had 6. Lily Saliba, Brooklyn Underwood, and Hannah Shaw all had 4 in the contest. 2 each for Audrey Elrod, Sydney Moon, and Jenna Hall. Actually, I left out Jack Gherkin. She had 3 points in the contest. Only Elizabeth Tabor, along with Riley Reed and Brooklyn Cromwell, that played in the game tonight, did not score.
Riley had 2 and a nice assist from Lily Saliba.
That's correct. You're right. Can't forget about that. So only have so many
many
spots open on your score sheet.
Absolutely.
So when you're using 15 players, you got to try to finagle that just a
yep.
little bit. So don't want to leave her out, but
yep.
Thanks for the
correction. No problem.
For Christian Academy, pretty easy. Only 3 players scored tonight. Ashlyn Owen had 5. One of her baskets, a 3-pointer. And Ella McCoy and Aaron Stensrud had a field goal apiece there in the fourth quarter. Christian Academy had 13, 11, and 12 in their three games, but they cannot hit that tonight if they were held to just 9 points in the contest. And Lopez, Caitlin Estes started, did not score, and with only eight on the bench anyway for Christian Academy, Ashton Neighbors, Nicole Tucker, and Casey Souter all played but did not tally. 17-0 in Orleans after one, 36-2 at halftime, 52-5 after three, and then the final 66-9 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. An easy win for Orleans as they go to 4-1 on the year, dropping Christian Academy now to 0-4. Quick look at the final numbers.
Well, I thought, like I just said, the big numbers I talked about with Coach Gilbert, and that really, and you went through most of them, that really stuck out to me. I had Orleans for 29 rebounds in the ball game, and I had Christian Academy for 31 turnovers. And those are the two big ones that I thought, were the main difference in the game. Orleans in the second half, or for the game, they shot 26 of 62. That's a lot of shots for a girls varsity game at 41%. They shot better from the free throw line in the second half, which you alluded to as well.
All right, for the varsity all the way down to the elementary grades, your friends at Scott Doherty Trucking are proud to salute each student-athlete for their hard work and dedication in continuing the legacy of excellence that is Lady Bulldogs basketball. Good luck all season long from everyone at Scott Doherty Trucking in Orleans, keeping America's economy on the move. Get a 57-point win for the Orleans girls tonight as they take out Christian Academy 66-9 on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. We'll take one more break and wrap things up when we come back to Christian Academy High School in a moment. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
You've worked hard to build and protect your estate throughout your lifetime. Enjoy the confidence that comes from knowing all you've worked for may be preserved for your heirs. Please call Jamie Sullivan, Senior Vice President of Investments of Sullivan Financial Consulting of Raymond James, located in Mitchell at 849-2670. Jamie can help design a comprehensive plan suited for your family's future financial needs. Call Jamie Sullivan today at 849-2670. Raymond James and Associates Incorporated, member New York Stock Exchange, SIPC.
Sorry about that. Before we go any further, let's pause one last time, 10 seconds for station identification. You're listening to Orleans Girls Basketball.
You're listening to the 6,000-watt sports voice of the Valley, WFLQ, French Lick, Indiana.
Back for the final time at Christian Academy High School in New Albany, where Lady Bulldogs win big over the Lady Warriors. 66-9, the final score. Took Orleans a while to get going, but once they did, they were impressive, pouring on 17 points in the opening quarter, led by 34 at halftime, 47 after three, and go on to the 57-point victory. But the unfortunate thing, I guess, Aaron, they're not going to always be easy.
No, we just talked about how tough their schedule gets in December, and they play some really good teams. This is a night that you got to just come down and you take care of business and get off to, you know, and just, you know, you get a lot of kids and you want to get a lot of kids in the game and you want to play as well as you can and keep the intensity up, even though, you know, and I thought the Christian Academy's credit, I thought they played hard the whole game. And like you said, the execution wasn't there. But this is a good win for Orleans, and now they've got to just try to get better, as Coach Gilbert was talking about, because they've got a rough stretch coming up here.
Right. Just three juniors on this Christian Academy team out of the eight. The rest are freshmen and sophomores. So they'll have a couple of years, Will Chris Jefferson, to work with this squad, but certainly a challenge for them this year. And as you mentioned, what a schedule coming up for Orleans here, among other teams. We mentioned a few of those being Lagodi, Salem, yeah. Springs Valley, Paoli, Trinity Lutheran having a good year.
The Salem game has been dropped. It's Eastern Green.
Okay. Oh, that's right.
But again, Eastern Green will be a tough game for Orleans because it's on the road as well.
Yep. Actually, you're right. Forgot all about that. I've got an old schedule, I guess, so. At any rate, good thing, because Salem having an outstanding year to this juncture.
Very talented ball club.
All right, enjoyed our trip down.
I
guess we'll be making the trip back here as well. At least you're hoping anyway, right?
Yes, sir.
Just kidding, but we appreciate your comments and look forward to having you on again sometime here in the near future.
That'd be great.
All right, here tonight, three double-figure scores for Lanes. 17 out of Sheridan Robbins, 12 off the bench from Lily Pridemore, 10 more from Haley Powell, as the Lady Bulldogs defeat an overmatched Christian Academy team tonight, 66-9. They were led by Ashlyn Owen, who had five. Christian Academy now 0-4 on the year, 0-4 here. They played all their games to this juncture at home. Orleans will improve to 4-1 on the year, and they stay perfect away from the friendly confines of the doghouse as they are now at 3-0. Orleans has now won two straight in the series, and they win here on this floor for the first time since January the 29th of 2013. Christian Academy off until Saturday when they travel to Borden, and Orleans will have a little over a week off before they return home to face the Ligoti Lions of Coach Brian Smith on November the 27th. As always, we're grateful to our many advertisers who have allowed us to bring this game into your home, car, business, wherever you might be tuning in, and we're especially appreciative of the cooperation we receive from our participating schools, so we send a thank you to the administration and coaches for both Orleans and to Christian Academy High School. We hope you've enjoyed tonight's broadcast as much as it has been our pleasure and privilege to bring it to you, and we'll be back with us again tomorrow night. Should be a fun one as the Springs Valley boys, the defending sectional 64 champions, unveil their 18-19 squad as they host the Mitchell Blue Jackets. Right before that, we'll have the Springs Valley and Mitchell girls game. That's scheduled for 6 o'clock tip, so our broadcast coverage will begin at 5:45. Our next broadcast of the Orleans girls will be a week from Saturday on December the 1st. They'll head to Little Cincinnati to take on the Eastern Green Lady Thunderbirds. That'll be, I believe, is a 1:30 start, I think, a noon JV. Am I correct on that? Noon JV start, 1:30. Our is scheduled tip, so we'll be on the air about 1:15 for that. For our studio engineer this evening, Randall Hamm, and for Aaron Free, this is Mike Hamilton, bidding you a fine and pleasant farewell from Christian Academy of Indiana High School in New Albany for tonight's final score on the Busick Insurance scoreboard. The Orleans Lady Bulldogs 66, the Christian Academy of Indiana Lady Warriors 9. This is Orleans Girls Basketball.
WFLQ thanks you for listening to tonight's presentation of Lady Bulldog Basketball. It's been brought to you by Busick Insurance in Orleans for home, farm, health, auto, life, and business. Call 865-2626. Hall Brothers Transportation in Orleans, meeting the shipping needs of the area for more than a decade. Orange County REMC, offering affordable long distance. Call 865-2229. Pipe Dreams Incorporated in Bedford for energy-efficient furnaces. Call 279-9594. Super Clean Car Wash, Maple Street, Orleans, and by Sullivan Financial, Raymond James & Associates Investments, Highway 60 and 9th Street in Mitchell. High school basketball, a presentation of Q100 Sports. You can best show your appreciation for this broadcast by telling and patronizing our sponsors. You're listening to your power station for sports, Q100, WFLQ, French Lick.